Okay. The next session is actually a really exciting one for me personally, but we tried this 2 years ago, which is a debate format on a topic we think is very important, which is collaboration. Year after year, we sort of debate, ask the same question, do we need it? Of course we do. How much should we support it? But rather than go into a default and have everyone say, of course we want collaboration, we're going to set it up as a debate. We're going to have a motion which is collaboration is the enemy of scale. So we're going to have people actually break this down a bit. And before we do that, we have a polling question. We'd like all of you to use the app and to please answer. And this is before we start the session. We have two teams, the for and the against. On the right hand, on my side behind me, will be the side that is for the motion, and against the motion is on the other side. I request the debate participants to please make their way up to the stage. We also have three jury members, one from the foundation, one from DSRA, and one from the alliance. It's AK, Neera, and Sarah, who will also request to come up on stage. Again, please see this as an opportunity to actually just have not just fun with it, but actually dig a little deeper into why do we collaborate, what are some of the actual benefits of it, and what are some of the costs that are associated with it. And we really, we are super excited for this session. So if you haven't voted, please vote. And now I'm going to call Anand Bhagwati from DSRA. He's the director for capacity building, who will be moderating the debate.
For those who think this is a rigged debate, it's not. And that will become quite clear as you see the intensity of the discussion. So if I can request the panelists to please come on stage. Firstly, those for the motion, which means against collaboration. Professor Chary. Let's have a round of applause, yeah? Dinesh ji. Saket. Hey. Sandhya. Please come, yeah. Wonderful. So we have one side of the panel here, which is going to be for the motion. So I again remind you, as an audience, please don't confuse this. I confuse it many times myself. For the motion means against collaboration, okay? Which means collaboration is the dash of dash. Collaboration is the enemy of scale. Now we have the other side, the other panel, which is against the motion, which is for collaboration. Kavita. Let's have a big round of applause. Priyanka from BBC. Hi. Pragyal. Is Pragyal here? Hi, Pragyal. And Bitush. Hi. So can I request our panelists to please take the seats, and you know, the right-hand side should be the first panel. So, Professor Chary, if you could, you know, Dinesh ji, this side, if you could, yep. Another round of applause for this. I should have expected Dinesh ji with you there. This had to happen. So I just want to spend a minute defining collaboration. And, you know, this group is highly collaborative, but we are going way beyond convening. So when we are voting for this, when we are talking about it, when we are going to defend this, think of the Indian freedom struggle. A very, very diverse group of people forsook their individual differences for a common outcome. This outcome was difficult. It led to, in many cases, loss of life. But they came together like never before and achieved the outcome. So right now, we are talking of collaboration, which is really to achieve an outcome and not merely to convene. So as you think about the motion, defend it, you know, oppose it, let's raise the bar on this. And, you know, we will have a structure which is going to enable both parties to really talk about this, challenge each other, but there is also a surprise element coming up. So the only hint I'll give is the audience should please not fall asleep and track the conversation, because there will be something similar to, you know, something I'm going to mention soon. So the audience will be active in this conversation. I'm going to request for opening remarks, and you know, the way this will run is, as you know, there is a 4-minute slot for both sides, and we will flip this. I'm going to actually request the first group to actually start talking for the motion. So if I can, you know, request the team for the motion to start, 4 minutes. The way it'll run is, moment the 4 minutes mark is getting up, a music will lightly start off, and it'll rapidly intensify. So we will hold time accordingly. So for the motion, please start with opening remarks, and then we'll transfer to the other side for opening remarks. We'll go twice on that.
Before that, allow me to introduce the group members. Savdhan, ba mulaiza, ba adab, shahanshahon ke shahanshah, FSSM ke mathadish, mathadishon ke mathadish, Professor Dinesh Mehta, Professor Chary, Fecal Sludge ke sardar, aur hamari mohtarma, Sandhya Haribal, aapke samne collaboration against collaboration ki baat karna hai.
Good morning, everybody. So we did speak of collaboration. We started about a couple of years back. And we started as a handful of organizations with the like-minded organizations working together. But now we've grown to such a huge size with so many filling up this whole room. So is that an easy job? Is it easy to hold together so many people? No, my friends, that's a big challenge. Collaboration needs a strong glue. It needs a very strong glue to hold so many people together towards one single target, right? And that glue is very, very expensive. It takes a lot of time, a lot of efforts, a lot of commitment, and continued support to take forward such collaborations, right? And one more thing is, collaboration, we are speaking in terms of achieving scale. But is it that simple? Because such a huge collaboration would also need a lot of inward-looking kind of strategies. It's at some point also dilutes the whole effort, because instead of aiming at achieving targets, at scaling up, we have to put in a lot of effort in bringing so many people together to work in the same direction. Thirdly, how continuous do we think this collaboration will go on, right? Are we really confident we'll be looking at each other, speaking to each other in 2030, 2035, 2040? Are we really confident? I see blank faces, so I'm looking for a lot more support, a lot more inputs in this to take this discussion forward. And I think now Professor Dinesh Mehta would also add on some points to this discussion.
Hi. When I heard that Anant was going to moderate this session, I said, I have to read up some management literature. So I went to Harvard Business Review and I found a paper, Nilofel Merchants, 8 Dangers of Collaboration. And so, Anand, this is for you. And I'm not going to read all the 8, but Nilofer, I think, rightly says that when you have collaboration, often there are unclear or undefined roles of all partners. And therefore, what happens is there is too much talking and there is too little action that goes on. And then in the pace of collaboration, there is an information overload. So you keep, and all the NFSM partners know how many WhatsApp messages do you get every day and how many thumbs up do you get every day. I think deleting that takes half a day for me at least. Nilofer says collaboration is also more like a feel-good thing. It's always nice to sit together and, we are collaborating. So it's a feel-good thing, but she says there are more hugs and handshakes than real action. And I think that really talks about, and somebody had put up a chart in the beginning, in the opening session, in talking about what is called, or what your management jargon they talk about, the collaboration premium. So what's the value add of collaboration? So collaboration premium is value added by collaboration minus the actual cost of collaboration, like this particular partners meet. I don't know how many FSTPs we could have built for the amount that we spent on this. And then the opportunity cost of collaboration. So I think to want to go to scale, we, Madhu herself said in the morning that collaboration is also working. If you want to go to scale, you have to work with the government. So each of these institutions, whether it is ASCI, whether it is CDD, whether it is KPMG, each institution on its own is very capable of working with the government to scale, and collaboration just stops us from doing that and halting us in that process. So that's under 4 minutes, but over to you guys.
Fantastic. Okay, what does the other panel have to start as opening remarks?
Thank you very much. Thank you to my esteemed colleagues on the other side of the stage, the Shehenshahs. Let me start by saying that what I've heard is not that you think collaboration is the enemy of scale, but that you think collaboration is the enemy of your comfort zone. What you'd really like is you'd like to stay in a safe space, in a safe environment, working with things you know how to do. And that's what we really want to be able to shake you out of. Now, you know, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm not a Jill of all trades. I don't think there are any Jacks or Jills of all trades here. So how does that work then when we're talking about scale? How's that going to work when we're trying to achieve these incredible, huge scaled, impact that we're aiming towards? I mean, Madhu says 50% of all fecal sludge treated by 2024. How are we going to get there if we're not all bringing our skills to the table? Now, you could say that we could do this one after the other. We don't really need to work in partnership. And, you know, yes, that's what we do in the morning. You wake up, you brush your teeth, and then you brush your hair. But what we really need to be able to do, most of us brush our teeth and then we brush our hair. But if you've got to collaborate and if you want to get to that kind of scale by 2024, we've got to find a way of brushing our teeth and our hair at the same time. And that's really what we've got to be able to change. Now, if this was 1913 and if we were, you know, Henry Ford and setting up an assembly line, it would make sense that we do bits and pieces one after the other and we do things, you know, sequentially. But that's not going to work, right? We need to be able to build technology. We need to be able to change policy. We need to be able to change hearts and minds of householders. We need to be able to create new equipment for, you know, practitioners to use. We need to be able to do so many different things. And how are you going to say that one is less important than the other and something else should happen first? Now, you know, collaboration is complex. I'll give you that. It's difficult. I'll give you that. It's time-consuming. I'll give you that. But you know what? When it works, it's beautiful. Think about those 5,000 dabbawalas in Bombay. For 125 years, without technology and without any massive systems and processes, they are able to deliver, you know, 260,000 transactions in 6 hours. And they've done this every day for 125 years. It's 2 lakh lunchboxes every day. If they can do it, why can't we? We're not 5,000 people. Surely we can get our act together a little bit more. So what I would pose to my esteemed Shehenshah colleagues across the platform is that collaboration is not the enemy of scale at all. It's an absolute imperative for scale.
Fantastic, thank you. So before getting it back to the other panel for, again, a new set of points, I think three things which it's coming out. Clearly, decisive action. Does collaboration actually enable or inhibit? And it's interesting, both of you are speaking about the same thing. Skill sets. Does collaboration add to complementary skills or actually doesn't matter? And finally, the premium. Is actually the premium more than the cost, which is an interesting question. So as I transfer back to this panel for the next set of comments, do dig a little bit into where you feel this might be relevant, and do you believe there is a nuanced answer, or do you believe it's a black and white kind of an answer? Back to you, sir.
Thank you. So I think I give a couple of examples to amplify my what my colleague said, that collaborations actually hampers the journey that many of us have embarked upon in achieving scale. What Priyanka ji was talking about is skill set gaps. If I want skill set, I would rather insource rather than collaborate. I would have a better control on the skill set insourcing capabilities if I need. If I need IEC behavior change capabilities, I would rather insource it rather than collaborate. So going back to the couple of examples, why collaborations have really hampered the journey of very, very fundamental journeys, I would like to draw the attention of the recent video of Mr. Gates inside Bill's brain. There's a very, very, while he talks about sanitation in part one, part three is about a very, very compelling, brilliant idea of climate change agenda, clean fuel. This whole clean fuel agenda fell through because two countries could not collaborate. A brilliant idea which could have changed the whole world and the way we conduct ourselves in terms of energy use fell through because of poor collaborative efforts failed in the process. So I think collaboration can often kill some brilliant ideas also. Now, what do we need in order to collaborate? First of all, in order to get scale, we need very, very clear understanding and alignment of vision, alignment of aspiration. And particularly in the development space, we need actually very strong alignment in terms of passion. I think it's not just about profiteering. If there are two commercial companies collaborating, there is a very clear understanding of profiteering is a motive. Profit making is a motive. In development space, often it is not that easy. So if we need very, very passionate, committed organizations and individuals collaboration, you need a common passion and common aspiration statement. And for that, you need a very strong cultural alignments. In fact, I would like to give you a couple of examples of why Walmart Bharti, as a very great example, failed a collaboration. In fact, it's a joint venture, which is much beyond collaboration because it's a legal process of collaboration. If you look at Mahindra's and Renault, again, it's failed. If you look at Bharti and AXA, these are some of the big players trying to collaborate and trying to amplify their skill sets and their own agenda, but they failed because of cultural differences. When you're talking about alignment of vision in this room, we all come from different cultures, we all come from different practices, and we all come from different leadership styles. We need cultural alignment, we need leadership alignment, we need actually the alignment in terms of pace and processes. And in the development sector, there are dime a dozen examples why collaborations actually reduce the amplification and actually, in fact, many sectors have failed to achieve scales because of poor collaborative processes. So what is the solution? The solution is about if there is a gap in terms of skill set, rather I would hire the skill set and amplify my work, number one. The second model is franchisee model. How could McDonald's could really achieve scale without going through collaboration? They have a model of what is called franchisee. So I think there are better ways of achieving scale through a concept of franchising, through a concept of insourcing, and actually rather than just blindly collaborate for the sake of collaboration.
I mean, just look at the word collaborate. It's like too much, you know, collaborate. I mean, just do it. Just do. And it's like aham brahmasmi. I am, therefore I am, and I can do. Ek mayan mein do talwar nahi reh sakte. For example, EY and KPMG, you think you can work? I don't think. Nor are the other big fours, right? Right? So, and moreover, you shouldn't collaborate. Why? Because...
Sir, can we ask him? So, Guru, can you collaborate with KPMG?
No.
Very, very difficult. Yeah, yeah.
Very difficult. Very difficult. Yeah. So,
we'll come to Guru later.
So that may be one of, but then it's rather, it's you should compete. Isn't it competition breeds innovation? competition breeds growth. Dr. Chary, I was just adding to your list, Tata Docomo also did not, you know, succeed. So overall, I believe like competition breeds growth, breeds innovation. There is no need to collaborate. Collaborate just an overused, it's become as fashion, it's become sort of like it's lot of people get free ridership just because in the guise of collaboration. You understand what I'm saying? A lot of people agree, right? They won't might say.
Okay, that's great. So thank you. And now over to the last set of opening remarks. Go at it.
Okay, to start with, I am the least prepared participant here. Okay, so I'm representing my boss, who's either traveling or maybe.
Ask Suresh as well.
Yeah, so I'm trying to add humor, as Krishnan said. So I'm representing my boss, who's either traveling or arranging documents for traveling most of the time. So I'm representing
it. So when you try to brush your hair and teeth together, this is what happens, right? Neither of them turn out well. You first brush your teeth and then brush your hair.
That was precisely the point we were trying to make, is that you cannot brush your hair and your teeth at the same time, and therefore you need somebody else, like Bitush is stepping in for his boss.
Thank you.
Okay, let's preserve civilities for just two more minutes.
Okay. So the two ladies here helped me to put some notes here, so please excuse me if I refer to these. To start with, Homo sapiens. So we survived because we came together. Our ancestors, they could live because they were living in small groups together. If you name the first villages, the first cities which came together, they could come together because they collaborated. If there was no collaboration, the first ship could not have sailed. If there was no collaboration, the first train could not have run. Yeah. If there was no collaboration, we could not have put men and women on the moon. Okay, so coming back to sanitation. If sanitation was all about building toilets, I agree we don't need collaborations. But sanitation is much beyond. We need to look at the whole chain. And that's the reason, even if we talk about single organizations, we collaborate with technology providers, we collaborate with governments, we collaborate with service providers, because if we want to look at the whole chain of sanitation, individually we can't do it. So, because it was very late and I wanted to speak for 4 minutes, I had to look for definition of collaboration dictionary. And the definition says that when a group of people come together for a common objective, that's collaboration. And I think that's the reason we all are here together, because we have a common objective. Otherwise, we would not have been together in this room. So I see a lot of collaboration here. In fact, the team, the Shehenshah team, has collaborated so well to talk against collaboration. I see collaboration. So even if this team wins, collaboration wins.
Okay, wonderful. Now, we are going to throw in a googly. This team has the right to tag anyone in the audience they can see. Essentially, two clauses. One, you have to see that person. And secondly, you can't tag someone in the opposing team. You have to tag someone in the audience. You can't brief that person. You just ask that person to say, please speak. What that person speaks is going to determine your predictive ability. So over to you.
I wish I could. Yes.
So Professor Mehta says Sakshi.
Okay, no biasing the audience. Sakshi, over to you.
Collaborate. As an institution, if I get the money from the Gates Foundation, I do well. I build FSTPs in Odisha. I don't think I need to collaborate with a Kavita or a Priyanka Dutt. I have a day job. I do it very well. I don't have to hide someone's, for lack of a better word, mediocrity, because they are unable to perform in my collaboration. There's no incentive.
Thank you, Sakshi. Now I'm requesting the other team to tag someone in the audience.
Madhu. Madhu, we can see you. You can't hide. You can't hide.
Mics to Madhu, please. Mic to Madhu.
Aren't you tired of hearing me speak for collaboration, guys? I spent like half an hour talking about it. No, absolutely not. Look at the picture. Who's going to win in this? Tell me who's going to win. The team that collaborates. That's how we're going to get to Vision 2024. There is absolutely no way. And Professor Chary and Professor Mehta, you better quickly walk over to the other side. We might have to do a motion otherwise at the Alliance meeting next time. You all are the engines of that Alliance, so you better be for collaboration. But seriously, no, I don't think, I think I absolutely agree. You can't, even in our own lives, every individual life, forget about organizations, we can't move one step without collaboration. It's not possible. And we know that. And we know that, especially when women have to carry all the load, we know how heavy that is. Right? Men have to collaborate. We won't get women empowerment. We won't get gender integration until every man starts speaking for it. We need your collaboration for everything. We need each of us to be champions for a cause. And we already saw it. All of you were working in silos. And we weren't getting this impact, right? The whole Swachh Bharat, the narrative is it's a Jan Andolan. Even if you had the Prime Minister and threw all the money at the world, in the world, you wouldn't get the kind of traction we got for 5 years. So there's just no question.
Thank you, Madhu. This was a bit of a last minute, you know, slog over hitting, so that was great. I'm going to now turn back to the team for one round and one round only of rebuttals. But just before that, summarizing some of the key points, and you know, please focus your rebuttal to three key points of rebuttal. I think the first point, which both of you covered, was the idea of control versus the idea of actually skill sets. There is, of course, a spectrum you drew, Professor Chary, around the most, you know, the situations where we have maximum control. And the situations where collaboration sometimes dilutes that. So there was one topic which you spoke about. I think the second topic you spoke about a lot was, you know, how does really mediocrity either sustain or get squeezed out in a situation where collaboration exists? And the last point is around, you know, in wicked problems such as this, which are non-linear, how do skill sets get built? And you know, are there actually pros and cons of that from collaboration? So as the audience also looks at what gets rebutted, please take notes on whether the rebuttals were convincing, because now this is going to be the literally the last round before we open it up for voting and questions. So over to you, sir.
Well, Bitush talked about definition. So definition of collaboration. So I also went to a dictionary and found what is collaboration. It says two or more institutions working together to achieve a common good. So there are three parts to this definition. Two or more institutions, that's team. The problem in collaboration, and as Chary alluded, is that we have often teams of unequals. So to bring everybody on board
it takes time. Now, it can achieve Madhu's goal of 50%, but it will take longer than 2024 to bring everybody together on that. The second thing is working together, which means processes. Now, collaborations has not yet worked out a good process. I mean, in corporate world also, we think of various ways of communication, internal, external. How do we really achieve? And I don't think within this space we have really worked out a good process. And finally, the purpose. The purpose is the only thing that is very clear. But often, people come with their own, each of these institutions has its own goal, has its own purpose. And to all, achieving a common purpose is again a very difficult task. And all we are saying is that collaboration is good, but it will be longer. So if you really want scale, then we may have to think about other processes. And finally, I just want to leave you with this, again, all these management guys like, you know, case studies. So the famous case study is of John Kennedy's and the Bay of Pig, the Cuba episode. And apparently, management guys talk about this as the group think, or what do they call? Wisdom of group. And when Kennedy asked his group of advisors that what should he do, should he really launch this attack, none of them dared to speak out in this group that this is a wrong decision. And so they went ahead and it was a debacle. So problem with collaboration is that half the people don't speak along with the free riders. So the ways to express again, I think that space is often not provided and only a few speak. Only people like Chary speak or only people like Saket speak and not everybody else.
20 seconds intervention. I think collaboration is about too many goals, too many leaderships and too many egos. I think people often confuse collaboration with partnerships. What Madhuji mentioned is about partnership with citizens, partnership with 1.3 billion citizens. It's not collaboration. So I think we need to differentiate between partnerships and collaboration. Collaboration is about egos, leaderships, multiple goals, multiple visions, and multiple cultures. We need a leader like Prime Minister to define the you know, aspiration, define the scale. And for that, partnership is one of the mechanisms to achieve that scale.
Just one bit. So wolves collaborate to hunt. After the hunt is complete, they compete for the flesh. Right? So there is nothing in collaboration.
That's the consulting firms.
Okay, I think
second, that's last. Just to sum up our argument, कहाँ किसी के लिए है मुमकिन सब के लिए इकसा होना थोड़ा सा दिल मेरा बुरा है थोड़ा भला है सीने में डोंट कोलैबोरेट
इट साउंडेड वेरी गुड सो थैंक यू एंड यू नो जस्ट बिफोर पासिंग ऑन देयर इज अ स्लाइट शिफ्ट व्हिच दिस टीम इज स्टार्टिंग टू डू स्पेशली आफ्टर मधुज इंटरवेंशन व्हिच इज टैक्टिकली शिफ्टिंग इट यस सो आई एम गोइंग टू ब्रिंग यू बैक टू टॉपिक व्हिच इज There is no change in the question. Collaboration versus partnership is not the question. That team is arguing, saying collaboration doesn't work. So just reminding this group. Back to this panel.
So you said that we don't collaborate with the citizens. We partner with the citizens. But when Alkesh talked about in the morning that the 67 years did not work and 5 years worked, the last 5 years, going back to your point, government always thought exactly the same point that I'm the Shahenshah, I can do this job. They never wanted to partner and collaborate with the folks all here who are present here. And the result that we are seeing today is exactly the opposite of what government thought. And today, in last 5 years, when the government started collaborating with each one of us, we are seeing the magic, we are seeing the music. So going back to the point that the partnership with the citizens and the government did not work, it has shown the results. And today we have the goalkeeper award as well for coming to India, exactly on the same point. Talking about your point about ek mayan mein do talwar nahi reh sakti hain, we give the data to you and that you present to the national.
तलवार तो फिर भी नहीं रह सकती, तलवार फिर भी नहीं रह सकती. मैं आपका फायदा उठा रहा हूँ.
No, but to build upon that, in an FSM alliance, we have ENY and we have KPMG, and you're on the same dais, even if you're on the other side. So clearly, you're together in collaborating in some form. And my only point I wanted to add here was, we often say that collaboration is made out to be in the enemy of mediocrity. That's not the motion. But there is no guarantee that you are going to not collaborate and succeed. So I think often, people use mediocrity or excellence rather as an excuse for not collaborating. There is really no evidence for this. And I think people made a point about, I think Sakshi or somebody made a point about that, I'm kind of, they're free riders. But even within an organizations can carry mediocre people along it. I don't understand why is it only when it comes to inter-organization thing that collaboration becomes such an issue. Because I think partnership, collaboration semantics. We collaborate with the government, we collaborate with technology partners, we collaborate with each other. And I mean, look where we've come. We are again talking about going from 5 to more states. We had a discussion the other day and we said we can do it in a shorter time. I'm sure that's not possible if we had all not learned common lessons along the way, right? So yeah.
Partnership with states, collaboration is without states.
At this stage, I don't know how many times people from my team has called somebody from the SEP team, because we know you've been doing better, and ask him, can you give us a solution to this so that we don't make the same mistakes? And we've not made the same mistakes because we've listened to you, and I hopefully you've also listened to us.
So along with collaboration, there also has to be a driver, there has to be a leader to push things through, so that is equally important, and that's what leads us towards the target.
Leader. Collaboration does not preclude leadership. We have leadership in the alliance. Does anybody doubt that?
I meant to say leadership among the collaborations, collaborating partners. Like one single entity has to drive it. There has to be a catalyst in the motion, right?
So we have a good heated up, and I think the two teams are now starting to catch up neck to neck. So 1 minute, and only 1 minute to close the remark. You can close with a poem, but be loud about it. And but please summarize what you wanted to say in a closing remark, and then immediately we'll flip it back to the other team. After that, the audience and the jury should spend a little time introspecting, and then we'll talk about how the voting will work. But over to you, sir.
This is what happens when you collaborate.
So it's like one person has set the vision. All of us are aligning to ourselves, to the vision, our resources, our efforts, and everything. Is it collaboration? No. The vision is there, and if particularly for scale, attaining scale, as Professor Dinesh Mehta mentioned, that if you have to achieve this goal of 2024, if you collaborate, there is a lot of energy that will be lost in collaboration, building consensus, and all of that, you know, that stakeholder approach and consultations, they lead nothing. I have been to hundreds of them, let me tell you. Within the government, I'm looking at it, the government also asks information from this. Let's reach out to states and see what they have to say about, say, fecal sludge or about, say, Amrut, why those. Everybody bloody knows why it is not working. All right, so there is no point in it. I mean, collaboration is just a waste of time, waste of effort, waste of resources. Moreover, all we need to do is just fix the goal, look at it, build a team, work on it, achieve it. No need to go here and there. No need to waste your time, energy, resources looking at anyone.
You want to end on a poem? Saket? Okay, exhausted the poems. Okay, good. Thank you. Thanks to this team. Over to you.
Okay, so I'm going to turn to the audience. So for me, as being part of the alliance and in generally being part of this community, APM is a very big place where we come together to collaborate. So how many in the audience would rather be sitting at a computer right now than being here? How many of you here are here because you've been forced to? The restaurant and the Gates team have been chasing you to attend this. How many are here because you believe it's fun? Okay. How many of you are here for the fun social night? How many of you here? My God, none of you are excited to be here.
Exactly.
No hands. Madhu, there are no hands going up.
Exactly. This is for fun. This is for fun. Because of the social night. This is for fun. All of them have assembled for fun. Right?
But
just taking time off away from work,
AK,
right?
You're not here for fun.
Yeah, he is. He's going to drink tonight. You'll see.
Okay, no. So my point is, yes, that's my,
Kavita, that is my point.
No,
you can't do forced collaboration.
Collaboration for fun. And moreover, this is forced collaboration.
That's my point.
This is unfair.
No,
this
no,
is
no.
a forced collaboration.
That is my point, that we have been making out collaboration to be this bitter medicine that we have to eat. I think collaboration is fun. And we form wonderful friendships in this group of people, which I think is far beyond the 50% treatment that
we are
That
is what collaboration is all about. Socialization, friendship, and all that.
Does anybody have a problem with
scale
that?
And all
no
of this?
No serious work, no serious work, right?
Okay,
everybody loses their vision where to achieve. So just get.
You know. Yes, thank you. Firstly, big round of applause to both teams. I think the child, I think inspired by maybe this photo, the child in all of you came out. Especially the, you know, the school child. And as we now transfer it on, there's a song which we'd like to hear, and then we'll take it from there.
कंधों से मिलते हैं कंधे कदमों से कदम मिलते हैं हम चलते हैं जब ऐसे तो दिल दुश्मन के हिलते हैं कंधों से मिलते हैं कंधे कदमों से कदम मिलते हैं हम चलते हैं जब ऐसे तो दिल दुश्मन के हिलते हैं
अब तो हमें आगे बढ़ते हैं रहना अब तो हमें साथी है बस इतना ही कहना
सो thank you for the music. This is to just make sure this panel doesn't break the collaborative itself. I'm going to request the jury to deliberate. They're already doing that. Please do keep three things definitely in mind. Think of the structure of the argument, the effectiveness of the rebuttal, but also humor. And also factor in the fact that it is hard to argue against collaboration in a field, in an audience like this. While the jury is thinking this through, if the audience can now vote, and this is important because I think the audience vote and the jury vote will be compared. So if you go to your app, is the app already having the question? If you can please vote again on the same question you voted in the beginning, and please do not display the answer right now. We will display the answer after the jury votes. Raise your hand if you haven't voted. Okay, great. Over to our jury, who is, I think, very excited to share their thoughts and feedback. Over to you. Is the mic? Can we get the jury mics on?
Oh, it's on. We didn't have enough time, and we thought it was very difficult to decide. But we're leaving Sarah with the excitement because she's our guest. AK and I thought she's the guest judge. It was very energetic. For this side, which I thought they were very strong hecklers. I feel like I'm in high school and I get to be the teacher. So I thought they heckled a bit too much, but extremely creative. He brought Harvard research, which was a special place in my heart. They brought humor, examples, and actually brought alternatives. This side, yes? Then, and we just wanted to do a shout out to everybody clapping around Free Rider. Yes? Then there was the must collaborate side, which finally decided to define what it means to collaborate. So we felt one of the biggest weaknesses was the lack of definition up front. Hello, debating 101. Can we please define up front? We did feel there were moments of too much politeness on this side, but then they unleashed at some point. We really liked the metaphor of brushing teeth and hair, and we were trying to do it ourselves. It seems like a challenging metaphor, but kicked off the metaphors. And then these guys finally realized maybe they can use some metaphors too. And we liked the examples that came, and we liked equal voice over here. We felt it was distributed quite well here. We thought here, not as equal. Oh, and getting out of your comfort zone, and we saw a big round of applause for that. These were two shout outs. Yes.
Hello. So before, I'm going to be biased because, before coming to as a judge, someone offered me in one of the group today. if you give me a favorable verdict, today evening I'll take you to Oberoi bar and get me a 2 rounds of whiskey. So maybe, yeah, whatever I'm going to talk, maybe it's going to be a little favorable to them. Right? So we are in agreement. So I'm not going to say who's that person, right? Right, so I'm not going to repeat the points shared by both the team, but I'll pick up 2 points. One is about Professor Chary was mentioning about McDonald, right? So the quality and all aspects and things like that. Maybe in some cases, maybe if you go to one of the place here in Vasnviga, they opened a shop. The business was not going well. They closed the job, the shop and moved away, right? Can we close the shop? It's not possible, right? Maybe there's a business not doing well and maybe they can save. But whereas our focus, our business, our mission is different, but in which you need to involve everyone. That way it is not maybe some sort of, business is not working, we can close and move, but it's our case. It's a multiple level of interventions, a lot of skill and capacity needed. So it is not possible for us, definitely. And also other side, Bithu's spoke about, particularly for this task involve several elements, right? So particularly for technology, innovation, and communication, management side, ICT. So this is a complex. So definitely it is not possible for single agency having all set of skill set. Definitely there is a greater need for collaboration because one organization having all the skill sets never possible, right? Definitely there is a need for bringing all partners together and working together. It is an essential part. That's what came up very clearly from the other side. And also we all know that the reality. So nearly after FSM policy from Government of India, nearly 18 or 19 states, they have come up with their own policy. It's because of not because of one organization here. It's the entire alliance behind. We worked in the state, we have worked in the city and also national level. That's the result. That's what 423 FSTPs are coming up. It's a result of the collaboration. And also when you talk about collaboration a lot, I was expecting those kind of points somehow. Maybe we are working, maybe last 11 years was Institute working with various partners. And I'm also in the sector for 30 years, worked in different collaborative platform. There are certain issues, always a problem that we need to address right at the start. One is about compromise, right? When many partners come in together, whether you give your focus around your branding in that particular association, or you focus around the vision of that particular thing. So sometimes the ego and all sort of things, my organization first. So can you, visibility point. So we need to have some sort of compromise around, that is a challenge. Another important thing, giving space. So someone was mentioning about, there are 5-6 organizations in the collaborative thing. Some may be very experienced, some may be new to this group. We need to give space, right? Always you try to do so dominant, then maybe never going to work. So that's what maybe those challenges how you overcome. Another important point is about coordination. I don't know, you must be knowing this story in Tamil Nadu. About 20 years back, one of the famous program was Social Forestry Scheme. It was not working well because there was not much coordination around. What had happened one fine morning, one officer, straightforward officer, went to the field. The roadside tree plantation, that was the scheme. One fellow was taking the pit, another fellow filling the pit. Then he went and asked, what's happening here? You are taking, another one is filling the pit, closing the pit. The reply was, the work was given to 3 contractors. One is digging the pit, another one is supplying the seedlings, third one is filling the pit. That particular day, the person who supplies seedling, he was on leave. This is about the coordination, right? This and all challenging element, definitely how you overcome. So you know from this, who offered me 2 rounds of whiskey today evening. Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks, Sarah. Over to you for your feedback. And then to announce, according to who's got the jury prize.
Okay, so I enjoyed both. I enjoyed the entire debate. And initially, I thought, actually, the team, the enemy of collaboration, did a really good job collaborating on their entrance. So they did look pretty polished because I think they collaborated. However, the collaboration side was calm, and I was able to follow them a bit more. Since we keep talking about brushing your teeth and your hair at the same time, I think it can be done, and I think it can be done with skill and innovation and practice. So collaborating just doesn't come easy. I think it's something that you need to practice, and I think together, if we practice together and we all have that one vision in mind for sanitation for all, that we can achieve our goals. So as we talk together here, the consensus came to be that collaboration won.
Woo. So I think a couple of interesting points. One is, it is a complicated topic. Clearly, even the audience has a fractured mandate. And clearly, the answer is not as black and white as came out in the situation. If we, you know, go back to, I think, what the jury also spoke about, I think the question at the bottom, which Dinesh G also spoke about, a really analytical view on where is the cost of collaboration higher than the benefit, and where is the benefit far more than the cost, might be an interesting one, because this audience actually has dealing with that on a daily basis. So just with that, and hopefully this has spurred your thinking on this topic, I'd encourage us to go deeper into this, talk a little bit more inside your organizations and across. But I'd like to congratulate the team and thank you for being a great panel. Thank you the other team as well for being a sporty panel. And thank you audience for participating.